My presentation is about digital competence in Europe, an approaching to Spanish and Norwegian framework. Since yesterday, that the team conference began, we have been talking and hearing about different and new concepts emerging in our network society related to education. Concepts like m-learning, e-learning, mobile devices, digital learning, smartphone, tablet. Okay, in this overall context, I would like to underline that the use and performance of all these issues depends mostly on the digital competencies teachers and students will have. So, therefore, this reflection allows me to introduce you the concept of digital competence in order to evaluate how it's being developed in our country in relation to Europe and specifically to Norway. So, we could say digital competence is quite a new concept. If we have a look back in time, we could realize that digital competence was a knowledge on the European recommendation on 8 key competencies on 2006 by the European Parliament. This key competence supported the specific needs and reflected new requirements for the society, knowledge, skills, and attitudes for the digital age. 4 years afterward, the value of this recommendation was recognized in the Europe Strategy 2020 by the European Commission 2010. The development of theoretical frameworks evolved from a descriptive and optional training to become an essential training to be acquired by all citizens. So, this argument brings us to the DIGCOM project, which was developed for a better understanding and the development of the digital competence. This project, DIGCOM project, was launched by the Information Society unit. Three were the main goals of this project, basically: to identify the key components of digital competence, to develop digital competence descriptors, and to propose a roadmap for the possible use of revision and revision of the digital competence framework and descriptors of digital competence for all levels of learners. It was the first and serious project for the development of the digital competence. As we can see in this table, the digital competence was improved in three different dimensions. Here we have the three. Competence areas, the digital competence was improved in an information area, in a communication area, content creation area, safety area, and problem solving. Secondly, the project developed the description of these competence areas in terms of knowledge, skills, and attitudes or application. And thirdly, in a practical proficiency. It means different levels of this digital competence, those competence areas. So we find a foundation level, an intermediate level, and advanced levels. If we translate this graphic into the competencies that were developed in each competence area, we could find that 21 different competencies integrate the digital competence for citizens to be digitally competent. So, we find in the first competence area, information, three different competencies: browsing, searching, and filtering information, evaluating information, storing and retrieving information. About communication, six different competencies: interacting through technologies, sharing information, engaging in online citizenship, collaborating through digital channels, netiquette, managing digital identity. About content creation, we had four different competencies: developing content, integrating and re-elaborating, copyright and licenses, and programming. About safety area, we have protecting devices, protecting personal data, protecting health, and protecting the environment. At last, but not least, in problem solving, we find four different competencies: solving technical problems, identifying needs and technological responses, innovating and creatively using technology, and identifying digital competence gaps. So, let's see, on the other hand, what happened in Spain. This is a general overall in Europe. Remind that those are specific, this is a specific project for the development of digital competence for citizens. Let's see what happened in Spain, in our country. On the other hand, let's see how digital competence was introduced in the Spain educational framework and how it has been developed. The digital competence was firstly introduced in the LOE law in 2006, endorsed as a key competence in the curriculum of primary and secondary schools, confirmed once again later in the LOMCE law 2014 without any change. Acknowledged as a cross-curricular competence in the curriculum, we hardly find any development about it since then. It means descriptions, writing, but not special actions about digital competence in Spain for teachers or schools. What happened in January 2014 was that was presented the draft about common frame for teachers' digital competence. If you read that, you may say, okay, there's something about digital competence. I have to be sincere with you. This was an exactly copy of the DigCom project developed in Europe for citizens. So, an important question. Are we in the right way to achieve a real development for a digital building, a digital education? Is there any possibility to develop a digital competence model for teachers? Yes, the response is yes. Here we have the Norwegian model. What happened in Norway? In Norway was developed a specific model for teachers instead of copying a model developed for citizens in general, as Spanish people have done. So, what is important in this model is being developed only for teachers. So, here we find two different axes to develop in a very deeper way the digital competence for teachers. Which is important of this model is the Norwegian government support it. So it means they make a special law for it. We find the white paper that supports this model and a special plan for teachers, the general plan for teachers' education in Norway. Secondly, we must highlight that in this model, teachers use technology, focus on education and teaching, and they should be role models in the use of ECT, discovering learning possibilities for pupils and students. So, here we can say how is defined the digital competence for teachers, which is evidently different from the definition for citizens. Digital competence is the proficiency in using ECT in a professional context with good pedagogic, didactic judgment, and his or her awareness of its implications for learning strategies and the digital building of pupils and students. Digital building is digital education. So, summarizing, here we have, more or less, the Norwegian model. It's worth noting that the Norwegian model merged the three key points for a real digital education, which are pedagogy, subjects, and digital competencies, which makes the real digital building. This is not a theoretical model, something written on paper. This is a model in practice, and it's in practice since 2007. So the good news is there is a model and it works. Finally, we could say that maybe in Spain we should have second thoughts about how we are implementing the digital competence in education for the digital age. And if we want to copy a model, maybe it would be better for us to copy a model specifically developed for teachers. So we have here more or less what we must do and we mustn't do. And that's all. Thank you very much for your attention.